a great time here at Studio 10, especially our studio audience. They are pumped. Oh, yeah. It must be because Steph and Dennis is our guest. Yeah. Oh.
It's like a blue light disco.
Isn't it? Are we well? Fabulous.
Very well.
Are you ready to rock and roll on a few hot topics?
Yes. Always ready to rock and roll, Sarah.
Oh, feeling dangerous, Aisha?
Always dangerous.
Never do me.
All right, let's get into it. First up, the consequences of not vaccinating your children have been highlighted dramatically by a young mum after her 15-day-old son was exposed to the potentially deadly measles virus in a doctor's office. Jennifer Hibben-White from Canada hit Facebook and her message was very clear. She said, she wrote, "If you have chosen not to vaccinate yourself or your child, I blame you. I blame you. You have stood on the shoulders of our collective protection for too long. From that high height, we have given you the privilege of our protection for free. Mm. And in return, you gave me this last week, a week from hell, wherein I don't know if my baby will develop something that has death as a potential outcome." Death. Gives you goosebumps reading that sort of stuff, doesn't it? It's a powerful message, Stefan. I might start with you on this one. It's getting to crisis point, isn't it, that the anti-vaxxer message?
Yeah, which is a bit silly. I mean, I remember the huge outcry of the MMR vaccination over in the UK when I was living over there, and we were in a dilemma ourselves because this was around the time that my first son was born. We deliberated and deliberated. And in the end, you know, we kind of talked into it, but then we realised, you know what? It's good. Mm. And it's, as this girl said, it's free. It's not like, oh, I've got to fork out hundreds of dollars to have my child vaccinated. And to protect them against measles or chickenpox or whatever, it's, come on, guys, use your noggin.
Have these diseases,
you know, and we've just got to look at far more deadly viruses, e.g. the HIV and AIDS viruses and all of that, which are spreading, and the Ebola virus over in Africa, how they spread. And it's okay, measles is, as this woman says, potentially very, very dangerous in young children, pregnant women, et cetera, et cetera. But, so, you know, if we can stop that by something that has been proven through the decades that it is relatively safe to give. I mean, I've been vaccinated. I'm sure all of you have been vaccinated. You know, we did it at schools. You lined up. You got your rubella. You got this. You got the other. Come on, guys. Think about it. Stop being ninnies and nannies.
I think people don't realise the consequences. Of course, it's a lot more dangerous for a small baby. Mm. That's why this woman is so concerned. I mean, you can get a baby who has measles could get pneumonia. 1 in 1,000 children, babies, little people that get measles get encephalitis. That's the swelling of the brain. You know, it's a really serious health issue. And following this outbreak in the States, there's been a lot of discussion over there about removing all the safeguards that people, not safeguards, but the excuses people use these days. So there are no excuses. Your child is not vaccinated, they will not go to school in America. Mm. That's the debate they're having.
And I think we need that, because to me the issue is, okay, if you want to be stupid on your own, that's fine, you do that. But if your stupidity is going to be having an impact on my children, my friends' children, and not just hurting them a bit, but potentially risking their lives, it is outrageous.
Because it's community, it's the herd immunisation that we need.
And one of the most infuriating things about this is that you have some of the crazy anti-vaxxer nut jobs, and send me your letters, please, because I don't read them, but who actually say, well, if everyone else is getting vaccinated, then why should my child get vaccinated? So there is even a mentality out there that they use it as a crutch. Mm. They use people doing the right thing as a crutch so that they don't have to, and have their kids, who are, you know, also innocent victims in this, running around potentially infected other people who, as we've seen in this case, people such as newborn babies who can't get vaccinated, who are incredibly vulnerable. The science is in. There is no debate about it whatsoever. That idiotic debate about the MMR vaccine that has been completely discredited. The Lancet, which published it, has completely withdrawn it.
Which is autism.
Absolutely wrong. The doctor has been completely disbarred. Yeah. It is absolutely beyond any shadow of a doubt, the best thing you can do to save your child and save the children around them from diseases we have wiped out decades ago. The best minds in the world have worked on fixing this problem, and now the stupidest minds in the world are trying to undo it.
Yeah. Some feedback Coming in on this issue, we have this from Lisa. Hell hath no fury than a mother whose child has been harmed. If someone's uneducated decision, Google is not educational, put my child at risk, that parent better start running, says Lisa. And this, vaccinations should be compulsory regardless of your place or country or birth, regardless of religion or beliefs. You don't want you or your child vaccinated, don't live here.
Yeah, yeah.